waste time. I'm just going to turn it right over to him and let him start the program.
Thank you, Warren.
Welcome, everyone.
Happy to have you here.
Yes, thank you very, very much for being here. You know, in the Psalms, number 9, the psalmist says, "Come and let us sing for joy to the Lord. Let us shout aloud to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before him with thanksgiving and extol him with music and with song." So let us begin. There be peace on earth, and let it begin with me. Let there be peace on earth, the peace that was meant to be with God as our Father, brothers all are we. Let me walk with my brother in perfect harmony. Let peace begin with me. Let this be the moment now. With every step I take, let this be my solemn vow to take moment and live each moment in peace eternally. Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me. Thank you. Well, you're going to hear some Christmas songs today, obviously, and then a few like that one and this one that just seem appropriate for a day when we have so much to be grateful for. I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, "How do you do?" They're really saying, "I love you." I hear babies cry. I watch them grow. They'll learn much more than I'll ever know. And I think to myself, What a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. I hate having my back to anyone here, but I do have to turn to play this beautiful, beautiful Yamaha instrument. What a joy it is to be here in Chetek with you folks that took time out of your busy days. My goodness gracious, you have so much to do. I know you do. we're all so busy. It just life becomes crazier as the year comes to an end. Isn't it something how it just picks up speed and keeps up going faster and faster? So every now and then we just need to take a breath and just enjoy the season for what it is, and that is so much joy. There's just that's the basic message that Jesus shared with all of us, and that is that he came about joy and celebration, and certainly we'll celebrate his birth here today. So I know all of you probably had your lunch beforehand, not downstairs today, unfortunately, but you probably ate lunch and you're ready to sing. I can tell. Looking at your faces, I can tell that you're ready to sing. So just pretend like there's nobody here and there's no audience, and we're not being streamed worldwide on the www, which, so hi to everybody around the world that's tuning in. And so
we are being streamed.
We are being streamed. Yes, yes. Daryl is in charge, so it'll go off without a hitch, I'm absolutely sure. So get your voices warmed up, and we'll sing an old favorite here. City sidewalks, busy sidewalks, dressed in holiday style. In the air there's a feeling of Christmas. Children laughing, people passing, meeting smile after smile. And on every street corner you'll hear, what do you hear, everybody? Silver bells. Nice. Silver bells. It's Christmas time in the city. More alto. Ring-a-ling. Hear them ring. Soon it will be Christmas Day. City street lights, even stoplights, blink up bright red and green. As the shoppers rush home with their treasures, hear the snow crunch. What snow, huh? So this is Santa's big scene. And above all this bustle you'll hear. Sing it out now. Silver bells, silver bells. It's Christmas time in the city. Ring-a-ling, ring-a-ling. Hear them ring. Soon it will be Christmas Day. Soon it will be Christmas Day. You sound great out there, just marvelous. I just love hearing people sing. And Some people say, oh, I can't sing. Everybody has a voice, can sing out, and I think it's a joyful noise. I think it was referred to in Scripture as a joyful noise, and that's just fine. So anytime you feel like singing along with the songs that I'm selected here today. So I guess I'll just start out and say, are there any requests? Hearing none, I'll just go right on. I did ask about 5 people beforehand, and they all got this blank stare, and I'm the same way. When it comes to song titles, it's just like, oh, as soon as I go home, I'll think of what I wanted you to sing. But so I just picked out some of my very favorite holiday songs and some of my favorite gospel songs, and I hope that you enjoy them. But thank you so much for being here. This is such a privilege and an honor to once again be here. Last year we had to shut it down, and that was so unfortunate, but here we are and ready to celebrate once again together. Does anyone remember an old classic that starred Bing Crosby and does anyone remember White Christmas? Old, it is old, yes. It actually was probably, I don't remember the exact year, but I think it was in the 50s that it was cut, maybe in the 40s even. But anyway, it's such a great old movie, and it's very fun to watch, and it's very predictable. But what great songs, my goodness. Irving Berlin, and I'll actually do 2 of his songs that not from the same show, but this song came about when in the script, Bing couldn't sleep, so he walks downstairs at the ski lodge, if you remember the plot. And so he walks downstairs, and, well, of course, who's waiting there? But the love interest, Rosemary Clooney, is sitting there. She can't sleep either. So fate brings them together near the kitchen. And so what does any good crooner do? He bursts into song when she says, I can't sleep. So here's the little message that Irving Berlin came up with, which is always appropriate any time of year, actually. When I'm worried and I can't sleep, I count my blessings instead of sheep, and I fall asleep counting my blessings. And when my bankroll is getting small, I think of when I had none at all, and I fall asleep counting my blessings. I think about a nursery and I picture curly heads, and one by one I count them as they slumber in their beds. So if you're worried and you can't sleep, just count your blessings instead of sheep, and you'll fall asleep counting your blessings, and you'll fall asleep counting your blessings. And don't we have a lot of those? Yes, we do. Yes, we do. Well, actually, I'm going to do 3 Irving Berlin songs, and this one, of course, you all know, and it's the title from that. So now that you're warmed up, I expect to hear all kinds of great music coming my direction. So just sing it like you know it, as my old band director used to say. Just like the ones I used to know.
where the treetops glisten and children listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow. Okay, everybody, I'm dreaming of a white Christmas with every Christmas card I write. May your days be merry and bright, and may Christmas be white. Very nice. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. Well, back in those days, that movie was done just shortly, I believe, after World War II. And during World War II, there were lots of our young men and women that were far, far from home. And this next song was written basically with that theme in mind. And of course, I hope that almost all of you are going to be able to be home for Christmas, wherever that home might be. And what a joy it always is to be near family and friends and the community. And so this song I'll dedicate to those that have served in the armed forces. And you can just imagine some of them in the South Pacific, for example, or up in near Japan, or in Germany, in the trenches, fighting in France. And when they heard this song, it instantly went to number one. And among those that served, it was a very, very popular song. I'm dreaming tonight of a place I love even more than I usually do. And although I know it's a long road back, I promise you Christmas. You can count on me. Please have snow and mistletoe and presents under the tree. Christmas Eve will find me Christmas, if only in my dreams, if only in my
I do hope you're home for Christmas. That's my wish for all of you. Can I ask, get a little nosy here, but did any of you serve in the armed forces? Would you just raise your hands really, really high? Some way in the back, gentlemen there. Please give them all a round of applause. Without the sacrifices of the people that served our nation, we couldn't sit here as a free country and worship any way that we want to. That was what this whole country was founded on, was the freedom to worship the way that people wanted to and not the way the government or anybody else said that they should. So this song was written by an Army veteran. At the time, he was actively serving in the United States Army. He was at a little camp in New York in 1919, I believe it was, or 1918. So there he was, extremely talented musician. So the commander said, "Sir, would you write a little play for us? We want a holiday play." And so he wrote this song, and it turned out to be his prayer for the United States and for America. And so the prayer was written, the song was done, and he said, "Nah, this isn't right for this show." It was a comedy, basically, and it was about their camp and whatnot. And he just said, "It's not the time for this song," and he threw it in his suitcase, and he went on with his business. They had the show. And years later, in the 1938, I believe it was, things were very, very bad in Europe. People were being vilely herded up, and Hitler was making his move across Europe. And at that time, we weren't involved in the war yet, but Irving Berlin, once again, Mr. White Christmas, he called up his friend in Hollywood, and he said, "Kate Smith, Kate, would you sing a song with me that I wrote a long time ago?" And she said, "I'll be there tomorrow." So she hopped a plane, she went to New York, they rehearsed it once, they recorded it once, it instantly went to number one. And ever since that time, Irving Berlin, his family, his estate, has never taken a single nickel for that song. All of the royalties from God Bless America go to the Boy Scouts and Girl Scouts of America to this day. And so a tribute to them, but also to all of our veterans that have served. And I know you're going to know it, so please sing along. While the storm clouds gather far across the sea, let us swear allegiance to a land that's free. Let us all be grateful for a land so fair. As we raise our voices in this solemn prayer. You know it. God bless America. Beautiful. Land that I love, stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above. From the mountains to the prairies to the oceans white with foam, God bless America, my home, sweet home. God bless America, my home, sweet home. Oh, wonderful. Thank you so much. That's a beautiful song. And I know he's probably not listening. He's down in Texas, but I'll just say hi to my partner in the memories, Tim Stevens. He's down there working today. But he and I have been now, as of 2022, we'll be celebrating 50 years of making music across the United States. Yeah. Well, happy birthday, happy anniversary to the memories. Some of you probably have heard us at various places around the Midwest. And, we used to actually be quite up in this area quite often. We'd be at Layman's and Rice Lake. And we're going to return for, I believe it's our 36th or 37th year, perhaps, at the Tainter Theater in about 2 weeks. It's the weekend before Christmas, so if you have nothing going and you'd like to, even if you do, cancel it and come and hear us. It'll be worth it, I'll tell you. But we'll be singing Christmas songs at the Tainter Theater, and the box office is selling tickets right now. But anyway, the reason I bring up Tim at this moment is we sing a lot of these songs for audiences, summer, winter. We always sing God Bless America. We always like to dedicate it to our veterans, of course. And Tim Stevens grew up in Wheeler. And some of you know where Wheeler is. It's a suburb of Boyceville where I grew up. Yeah. He'll never forgive me for that one. But anyway, he grew up in Wheeler, surrounded by many, many Norwegians. And of course, the Stevens clan on both sides of his family. And so his mom and dad, both Norwegian. And I can still hear Harvey, his dad. I can hear that beautiful Norwegian brogue, because he was brought up with speaking Norwegian in the house. But then he learned English, but he had that beautiful lilt to it. So I'll dedicate this. Any Norwegians out here? Can you just raise your hand? Oh, my goodness, great. Wow, I don't remember that many ever. That's great, you Scandinavians. Yeah, sure. So I'm going to sing a little. This was a Norwegian tune. So those of you that speak Norwegian well, please give me a little grace here, because I'm not Norwegian. I wish I were. I love the food, of course. I love lefse, and I'm assuming that some of you may have brought some packages of lefse for me. Just leave them on the table up here. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So a beautiful little song. I'm just going to sing one of the many beautiful verses to this. But hope you enjoy it. Sing along if you know it.
Jeg så glad før julig felt, de da ble Jesus fyrt. Da lyste stjernen som hun så, og engler sang så surt.
Isn't that gorgeous little melody? And in English, sort of like this.
I am so glad each Christmas Eve, the night of Jesus' birth, then like the sun the stars shone forth, and angels sang on earth.
I just love that little tune. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, sure, right away then, you know, I sort of get in the mood there. I can hear Harvey's voice, and I don't do it really well. But this is one that he didn't teach me. It was written by a friend of Tim's and mine, and it kind of goes, oh, no, it wasn't. I'm sorry, this is an old standard. I think it was written by a fellow from Minnesota, you know, you know that state? You've heard of it? The state that wishes they had a professional football team? Careful. We're on the web. I know I'll be getting calls tonight. I know that. Oh, lutefisk, oh, lutefisk, how fragrant your aroma. Oh, lutefisk, oh, lutefisk, you put me in a coma. You smell so strong, you look like glue. You taste just like an overshoe. But lutefisk, come Christmas Day, I think I'll eat you anyway. Oh, lutefisk, oh, lutefisk, how well I do remember
On Christmas Eve, how we'd receive our big treat of December. It wasn't turkey or fried ham. It wasn't even pickled spam. My mother knew there was no risk in serving buttered lutefisk. Oh, lutefisk, oh, lutefisk, I pute you by the doorway. I wanted you to ripen up just like they do in Norway. A dog came by and sprinkled you. I hit him with my overshoe. Oh, lutefisk, now I suppose I'll eat you as I hold my nose. Oh, lutefisk, they cooked you up and brought you to the table. And suddenly you made the house smell just like a stable. The odor headed down the hall. It peeled the paper off the wall. Oh, lutefisk, I'm not so sure just how you got so popular. Oh, lutefisk, oh, lutefisk, when my poor heart stops beating, those pearly gates will open wide. I'll see those angels eating from steaming platters of that stuff. And there will always be enough. Oh, piece of cod that I adore. Oh, lutefisk forevermore.
Oh, yeah. My apologies to you Norwegians, but, you know. Yeah, somebody once described lutefisk to me as the piece of cod that surpasses all understanding. I don't know about that. I'm allergic to fish, so I can't eat lutefisk or anything like that. But so here's a little sing-along for you. A good excuse? Yeah, that I can't eat it? Exactly. Sing along.
Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child. So tender and mild, sleep in heavenly peace, sleep in heavenly peace.
Oh, yeah. A beautiful German song there, and written for guitar. I guess the organ broke in the little tiny church in Germany where the author was, and all he had was a guitar, so he just quickly changed it and sang that beautiful song. And whenever we sing that song, we think of the baby Jesus in the manger, of course, and we think of all children, not just Jesus's birth, but the birth of all children, which is such an amazing miracle. I'm about to be blessed with the birth of my third grandchild. I have a four-year-old, one and a half, and one due in May. And I just love those little guys so much. I have two boys so far. So that gets Grandpa going, I'll tell you. And how many of you have children? A lot of people here? Almost, yeah, quite a few. I do not have children of my own, but I really won the lottery when I married my wife, Jane, and immediately became a grandpa. This song, The Memories, have done everywhere, almost every single show that we've done for many, many years. And it's for all the parents, the grandparents, maybe some great-grandparents. Do we have any Great. Look at the hands there. My goodness. What a mature audience we have. That is awesome. That is just awesome. What a blessing. So, here it is. If it weren't for kids, have you ever thought there wouldn't be a Santa Claus? Well, look what the Lord just brought. Thank God for kids. And we'd all live in a quiet house without Big Bird or a Mickey Mouse and Kool-Aid on the couch. Thank God for kids. Thank God for kids, there's magic for a while. Special kind of sunshine and a smile. Do you ever stop to think or wonder why the nearest thing to heaven is a child? Daddy, how does this thing fly? And 100 other wheres and whys. I really don't know, but I try. Thank God for kids. When I look down in those trusting eyes that look to me, I realize there's love I just can't buy. Thank God for kids. Thank God for kids, there's magic for a while. A special kind of sunshine and a smile. Do you ever stop to think or wonder why the nearest thing to heaven is a child? When you get down on your knees tonight and thank the Lord for his guiding light, pray they turn out right. Thank God for kids. Thank God for kids. You're so kind. You are so kind indeed. And, you know, speaking of kids, back over 50 years ago now, it's hard to believe that, but a couple of gentlemen went to a guy who lived, I believe, in the Twin Cities at the time. I'm not sure where he ended. He probably went to California eventually, but his name is Charles Schultz. And Charles was an amazing animator. He was doing comic strips, of course, called Peanuts, and probably one of the most popular of all time. And so some writers out in Hollywood thought, oh, I think Peanuts would be really cute if we'd make a cartoon. Okay. So they call up Charles Schultz, and they meet with him, and he said, sure, we can do that, but I have one condition. Well, what's that, Charles? And he said, as long as the gospel is told in the story about the birth of Jesus Christ. And they said, well, maybe not. We'd like to do it, but we have to reconsider this. And he said, those are my terms. If that doesn't happen, Peanuts will not get animated. So they thought about it two or three times, and they hired a very inexpensive animating company. I think they used some people from foreign countries even to draw all of the little sheets that need to be drawn. And of course, it came to fruition. And now it's a classic, and it's only 20-some minutes long. It's very short. But one of the most powerful things in there, of course, is the scene where Charlie Brown is just going... He actually picks up this, you know. Hope you can see that around the world. Yeah, he picks out quite an incredible little conifer, and he brings it to the other children, and we know how children can be just as mean as adults, and they ridicule him for his choice of a tree. And so he comes up with these lines, Charles Schulz did. "I guess you were right, Linus. I shouldn't have picked this little tree. Everything I do turns to a disaster. I guess I really don't know what Christmas is all about." Isn't there anyone here who understands what Christmas is all about? Charlie's standing on stage, of course. And then you hear from the side, Linus replying,
"Here he is."
He was playing a shepherd. There's little Linus. He goes, "Sure. I can tell you what Christmas is all about, Charlie Brown." So Linus proceeds to drag his little blanket out on stage, and he starts in with this. "And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flocks by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said to them, 'Fear not, for behold, I bring you tidings of great joy, which will be to all the people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in the manger.' And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, 'Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men.'" And that's what Christmas is all about, Charlie Brown. "I've heard about this baby boy who came to earth to bring us joy, and I just want to sing this song to you. It goes like this: the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift. With every breath I'm singing hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. A couple came to Bethlehem, expecting child. They searched the inn to find a place, for you were coming soon. There was no room for them to stay, so in a manger filled with hay, God's only son was born. Oh, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. The shepherds left their flocks by night to see this baby wrapped in light. A host of angels led them all to you. It was just as the angel said, you'll find him in a manger bed, Emmanuel and Savior. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. A star shone bright up in the east. To Bethlehem the wise men three came many miles,
and journeyed long for you. And to the place at which you were, their frankincense and gold and myrrh they gave to you, and they cried out, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
So much. Do not be afraid. The angel said to the young girl named Mary, announcing the incredible news that she was going to be the mother of the Christ child. Be not afraid, she said to the terrified shepherds on the hill that first Christmas night. Be not afraid. And we all, in one way or another, know the feeling of fear. It's human. Perhaps we fear getting older, losing our strength, losing our health. Perhaps the fear of an uncertain future. Maybe it's the fear of losing a loved one, the fear of what will happen in a relationship. The fears are real. But the good news that breaks in upon our world at this time of year, especially in every Christmas and every day, are the words of that angel: be not afraid. In a world that doesn't take away the concern of the cause of the fear, certainly, but it reminds us we no longer are in that fear by ourselves. We're not alone. Emmanuel means literally, God is with you and me. There are still fears in our lives, but Christmas comes again. We hear the word of the angel spoken new to us. Behold, do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy, which will come to all the people, for unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And in our fear-filled world, that birth makes all the difference. Sometimes, don't you wonder what it must have felt for, well, Mary, certainly. And Mary has many songs written about her. But Joseph, not so much. You wonder how this man was told that he wasn't going to be the father of the child, but he was going to be the stepfather of this little baby. And a song came to me a number of years ago that sort of wraps up what Joseph might have felt. We of course, don't know. There's not much in Scripture about Joseph, but I'm going to sing this little song, and I hope you sort of can imagine just what he might have been going through. How could it be, this baby in my arms, sleeping now so peacefully? The Son of God, the angel said, how could it be? Lord, I know he's not my own, not of my flesh, not of my bone. Still, Father, let this baby be the Son
of my love. Father, show me where I fit into this plan of yours. How can a man be father to the Son of God? Lord, for all my life, I've been a simple carpenter. How can I raise a king? How can I raise a king? He looks so small, his face and hands so fair. But when he cries, the sun just seems to disappear. But when he laughs, it shines again. How could it be? Father, show me where I fit into this plan of yours. How can a man be father to the Son of God? Lord, for all my life, I've been a simple carpenter. How can I raise a king? How can I raise this king? How could it be? This baby in my arms, sleeping now, so peacefully, the Son of God, the angel said, how could it be? How could it be? When Christ was born. His gospel is peace. Chains shall he break, for the slave is our brother, and in his name all oppression shall cease. Sweet hymns of joy in grateful chorus raise we. Let all within us praise his holy name. Christ is the Lord. All praise his name forever. His power.
Would all leave. Well, thank you, and that was a wonderful afternoon, just as we always expect. And I want to thank all of you for coming again. And normally we have a luncheon on this day, but because of what's going on, we do not. And so I will leave you with a few thoughts for the day. I will say a Christmas prayer for you, because the season's near, and I will not ask for riches, but for gifts that mean much more. For joyful gatherings with your family all around, and for carols to inspire you with their old familiar sound. I'll ask you for a quiet moment in your heart on Christmas morn, for a special time to celebrate there was a Savior who was born. I'll ask you for friends who send their best, that you might know that they care. I will ask for peace, love, know God, and know that God will hear our prayer. Be filled with wonder, be touched by peace. Believe in a miracle. Thank you all for coming. He says he has some CDs over here for sale if anybody would like to.
Thank you all so much.
Thank you again, Warren. Oh, that was his. Thank you.
Hey there. How you doing? Glenn. It's beautiful.
I just love playing this ground. For everybody who got the sheet, the date on there is December 11th. The cookie walk will be December 11th.
Oh, okay, okay.
This one's my soul, otherwise it's the memories. Yeah. And I've only got a couple copies of each one. But
you have, I think, two of the years or something.
Oh, yeah. I didn't even bring that one, I don't think.
Well, otherwise you have to work, so no.
Sure. Well, good.
There will be a free will offering in the back.